Let us continue hybridization. In the hybridization, we will take the molecule water. Water molecule we will take. In the molecule water, central atom is oxygen. Oxygen electronic configuration is helium 2s2 2p4. So the valence shell contains a 2s orbital and a 2p orbitals. 2s orbitals and 2p orbitals. As per VSEPR theory, water molecule shape, oxygen and two hydrogens like this. Oxygen comes under 6a group, so this valence shell contains 6 electrons. Out of 6 electrons, 2 electrons have gone for bonding. Remaining 4 electrons. Remaining 4 electrons are there. It is one lone pair. It is one lone pair. So central atom oxygen. Central atom oxygen in water has two lone pairs and two sigma bond pairs. So central atom oxygen has two lone pairs and two sigma bond pairs. Therefore, totally four electron pairs are there. So hybrid orbitals will hold lone pairs. Hybrid orbitals will form sigma bonds. Therefore, four electron pairs means four hybrid orbitals oxygen has to provide. Therefore, oxygen provides four atomic orbitals for intermixing from its valence shell. One orbital is 2s and three orbitals 2p. These four orbitals intermix to form hybrid orbitals. How many hybrid orbitals formed in the sense, how many atomic orbitals undergoing intermixing, that many hybrid orbitals will be formed. So four atomic orbitals undergo intermixing, therefore four hybrid orbitals are forming. The name of the hybrid orbital is sp3 because 1s and 3p, therefore each hybrid orbital name is sp3. Now let us fill the electrons. Here the valence shell contains 6 electrons, that 6 electrons will fill. First, for one orbital we are giving one pair that act as lone pair. For another orbital also we are giving one pair that act as lone pair. For remaining two orbitals we are giving one electron each because this will form sigma bond, this will form sigma bond. Therefore we have given like this. So this oxygen is having sp3 orbitals like this, sir. Now this sp3 orbitals will give this oxygen, we are writing oxygen. It is making sigma bond with the hydrogen. This sigma bond is formed by sp3 orbital of oxygen and s orbital of hydrogen. Next, oxygen making another sigma bond with hydrogen. This sigma bond is formed by sp3 orbital of oxygen and s orbital of hydrogen. Then this oxygen is having one lone pair in the sp3 orbital, then another lone pair in the sp3 orbital. This oxygen has a lone pair in the sp3 orbital. This oxygen has a lone pair in the sp3 orbital. This oxygen has this lone pair in the sp3 orbital. So oxygen has a lone pair in the sp3 orbital, we can say. Okay. So in the water, central atom is oxygen. Oxygen has hybridization sp3. It has two lone pairs in two sp3 hybrid orbitals. It has two sigma bonds. The sigma bonds formed by overlapping of sp3 of oxygen and s orbital of hydrogen. Now both bonds have same nature, therefore same bond strength, so same bond length. That means in water only one bond length is possible. Okay, this is hybridization of water, we can say. Next, so how to say hybridization in the sense, you see the number of lone pairs, then you take number of sigma bonds, then you take number of sigma bonds, total you see, that total you split into s, p, d. First you give to s. S means maximum you can give 1. P means you can give maximum 3. Maximum 3 you can give, more than 3 we cannot give because p subshell contains 3 orbitals. Therefore maximum 3 we can give. More than 3 we should not give. Remaining is there means give to d. In this way we have to say hybridization. Okay, sir. Now we will take a other molecules. We will take now we will take the molecule called SF4. In SF4, this SF4, if you take sulfur is the valence, sulfur is the central atom. This SF4, as per valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, we are writing the structure: 4 fluorine atoms, so 4 sigma bonds, and sulfur is having 1 lone pair. Sulfur has 1 lone pair. Sulfur comes under 6th A group. Therefore, this valence shell contains 6 electrons. 1 electron bonding, 2nd electron, 3rd electron, 4th electrons have gone for bonding. Remaining 2 electrons act as lone pair. So, in this sulfur, how many sigma bonds are there? Means 4 sigma bond pairs are there and 1 lone pair is there. Therefore, totally 5. So, how to say hybridization of sulfur? That we'll see. Hybridization of sulfur in the sense, now we will write SPD, we will write it. Out of 5, first in this 5 you take 2, S you take. For S you give 1. Remaining how many are there? 4. In that 4, you give to P. For P you can give maximum 3 you can give. Okay, then totally 4. So here 5 is there. Remaining how much? 1. That you give to D. So SP3D hybridization for sulfur. In SF4, sulfur hybridization is what means SP3D hybridization, sir. Next molecule we will take. XeF2. Next molecule we are taking XeF2. In XeF2, 2 fluorine atoms are there. So therefore, fluorine atom makes sigma bond with xenon. Fluorine atom will make maximum 1 bond. More than that, it cannot form at all. Fluorine atom can make maximum 1 bond. More than that, it cannot form at all. Okay. So fluorine is making 1 bond with xenon. This fluorine also making 1 bond with xenon. Xenon comes under noble gases. Noble gases in the sense, outermost shell has 8 electrons except helium, which has 2 electrons. It is having 8 electrons in the outermost shell. 1 electron has gone for bonding with the fluorine. Another electron has gone for bonding with the fluorine. Remaining 6 electrons are there. Here 2 electrons, 1 lone pair. Here 2 electrons, lone pair. Here 2 electrons, lone pair. Okay. Therefore, in this xenon, 3 lone pairs present and 2 sigma bonds present. 2 sigma bond pairs present. Totally how much in the sense? 5. So how to say hybridization? Hybridization means you write SPD, you write. First you give to S. S means maximum 1. P means maximum 3. Here 5 is there. In this 5, 1 we have given, 3 we have given, remaining is 1 that you give here. So hybridization is SP3D for XeF2. Here. How many lone pairs means 3 lone pairs, 2 sigma bond pairs. 3 lone pairs and 2 sigma bond pairs means we have to say the shape is a linear shape and bond angle is 180 degree. So remember that 3 lone pairs and 2 sigma bond pairs means shape is linear and bond angle is 180 degree, we have to say. Okay, we will take next molecule. Next molecule is what in the sense BrF5 we are taking. In the BrF5, central atom is bromine. That bromine we will write. Now, bromine comes under 7th A group. Bromine comes under 7th A group. So, this valence shell contains 7 electrons. So, 7 electrons I will write. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 electrons I have written. Bromine comes under 7th A group. Therefore, this valence shell contains 7 electrons. Those 7 electrons I have written. Surrounding atom is fluorine. Fluorine will make maximum 1 bond. That's all. So, fluorine is making 1 bond. So, each fluorine atom is making 1 bond. Fluorine atom cannot make more than 1 bond. Okay. So, you may ask a question. Fluorine and bromine both are coming under same group. Then, when bromine is forming more than 1 bond, why not fluorine? Because in fluorine, if you see, its electronic configuration is helium 2s2 2p5. Its valence shell configuration is 2s2 2p5. So it is having only one unpaired electron. Therefore, it can form only one bond. This valence shell is not having any more orbitals. Therefore, it cannot form more than one bond. But bromine, if you take what is the configuration, we'll see here fluorine, chlorine, then bromine. For this helium means for this neon, for this argon, for this argon. It is second period, it is third period, it is fourth period. Fourth period means 4s2 4p5. Then here what will be there means 3d10. So for the outermost shell is 4s2 4p5 4d0 4d0. So that here 4s we have written, 4p we are writing, 4p and 4d we are writing. 4d is having a how many orbitals means 5 orbitals. The valence shell is having 7 electrons. Those 7 electrons we can write even like this. The 7 electrons we can write even like this. So bromine is having maximum how many unpaired electrons, in the sense 7 unpaired electrons are there. In the it is excited state configuration. This is called excited state configuration. 7 unpaired electrons are there means bromine can form 7 bonds. Bromine can form even 7 bonds. Therefore, but fluorine cannot form 7 bonds. It can form only one bond only, because it is having only one unpaired electron. It is the ground state configuration as well as excited state configuration. Okay, sir. So BrFi, we have written this bromine is having one lone pair, and how many sigma bond pairs, in the sense 5 sigma bond pairs are there. Therefore, totally 6. Hybridization will say, now SPD we will write, for S you give 1. For B, you give, for P, we are giving maximum 3. Then here 6 is there. What is the remaining after distribution of this, in the sense 2? That 2 we will give to D. Therefore, hybridization of bromine is sp3d2, that we can say. So hybridization of bromine is sp3d2. Okay. So next molecule we will take, ClF3 we will take. In the ClF3, the central atom is what, in the sense chlorine. Central atom is chlorine. This chlorine comes under 7th A group, so this valence shell is having 7 electrons. This valence shell is having 7 electrons, you can see. Sir, fluorine can make single bond. Fluorine makes single bond like this. Sir, now chlorine is having how many lone pairs, means 2 lone pairs are there, 3 sigma bond pairs are there. 3 sigma bond pairs. So totally 5. So hybridization will say. So SPD we have written. First, S. S means 1. P means maximum 3. You can give less than 3 also. Okay. So maximum 3. Here total is 5. Available remaining is 1. That 1 we are giving to D. So hybridization of Cl is sp3d. Hybridization of Cl is sp3d, we can say. Sir, okay. Next we'll take XeF6, we'll take XeF6. This XeF6, in the sense central atom is xenon. This valence shell is having 8 electrons. This valence shell is having 8 electrons, that 8 electrons we will write. 8 electrons we have written. Each fluorine atom is making one bond. Each fluorine atom is making one bond. Each fluorine atom is making one bond. Now xenon is having one lone pair. Xenon is having one lone pair. And how many sigma bond pairs, in the sense 6 sigma bond pairs are there. So totally how much means 7, totally 7, one lone pair and 6 sigma bond pairs, totally 7. So what is hybridization? That we will see. SPD we will write. In this 7, 1 we will give to S, 3 we will give to P, so totally 4. In the 7, what is the remaining means 3, that 3 we will give to D. So what is the hybridization of xenon in XeF6 means sp3d3. sp3d3 is the hybridization of xenon in XeF6. Okay. Sir, now we have seen how to say hybridizations if lone pair is there. Okay, so remember that hybrid orbitals will form sigma bond pairs as well as can hold lone pair. Now we will take the molecule in which pi bond is present, that we will take. Now we are taking the molecule called carbon dioxide. In the carbon dioxide, central atom is carbon. Carbon electronic configuration is helium 2s2 2p2. 2s2 2p2. Now 2s is having one orbital, 2p is having 3 orbitals. Now 2s 2 electrons, 2p 2 electrons we have written. It is called ground state configuration. Now we will go for excited state configuration. Excited state, in the sense from 2s one electron goes to 2p. From 2s one electron goes to 2p. Therefore, excited state configuration of carbon has 4 unpaired electrons. Sir, now 4 unpaired electrons we have written. Next, oxygen we will take. Oxygen electronic configuration we will take. Oxygen electronic configuration is a helium 2s2 2p4. So 2s contains one orbital that has two electrons. 2p contains three orbitals. 2p contains three orbitals that has four electrons. That four electrons we have written. It is a ground state configuration of oxygen. Now this oxygen ground state contains two unpaired electrons. Excited state we cannot write for oxygen because the valence shell is not having any more orbitals. The valence shell configuration is 2s2 2p4. It is not having any other orbitals. Therefore we cannot go for excited state. Therefore oxygen is having two unpaired electrons, we can say. Sir, now we will see in this for this carbon dioxide. Okay, for this carbon dioxide, what I will do in carbon dioxide, I will take carbon is central atom, two oxygen atoms I have written. Now carbon valence shell is having four electrons. That four electrons I will write. Four electrons I have written. Okay, sorry. So carbon dioxide, carbon is central atom that is coming under fourth A group. Therefore that valence shell is having four electrons. That four electrons we have written in the form of dot. Oxygen valence shell is having six electrons. That six electrons we will write in the valence shell. So oxygen valence shell is having six electrons. That six electrons we have written. Now carbon valence shell is having four electrons. It is in need of still more four electrons to get octet configuration. Therefore carbon can make four bonds with respect to covalent. Oxygen valence shell is having six electrons, so it is in need of two electrons. Therefore it can make two bonds with respect to covalent. So here what is happening in the sense, carbon is contributing one electron, oxygen also contributing one electron, both are contributing one electron each other. Therefore a sigma bond is formed. Now both are contributing one electron with each other, therefore another bond is formed here. Now here both are contributing one electron with each other, therefore one bond is formed. Here both carbon and oxygen contributing one electron with each other, therefore one bond is formed. Now carbon valence shell is having four bonds. Four bonds means eight electrons. Therefore it has got octet configuration. Oxygen valence shell has two lone pairs and two bond pairs. Two bonds means four electrons. Two lone pairs means four electrons. Totally eight electrons in its valence shell. Therefore this oxygen has got octet configuration. This oxygen is having two bonds. Two bonds means four electrons. Two lone pairs means four electrons. Totally eight electrons in its valence shell. Therefore this oxygen has got a octet configuration. This oxygen has got octet configuration, we can say. Therefore this carbon dioxide is a octet molecule. This carbon dioxide is obeying octet rule, we can say. Sir, now you see that between carbon and oxygen, what bond is there? Means a double bond is there. Double bond means always one is sigma, one is pi. Okay, double bond means always one is sigma and one is pi. Okay, now this is a double bond, therefore it is one sigma, it is one pi. Okay, so remember that double bond means always one sigma bond and one pi bond. Okay, another point you have to think that whatever the rule is there, whatever the point is there, whatever the point, that will have exception. Okay, whatever the rule is there, that will have exception. In this universe, no rule is having no exception. That means every rule is having some exception. Sir, that means here what we are going to do, what we are going to say, here it is a double bond. One double bond means one is sigma, one is pi. That is only general. But what is the exception? Now we will take a molecule. This molecule we will take. In this species, double bond is there. Both bonds are pi bonds. Both bonds are pi bonds. So like this exception will come. Okay, therefore a double bond means generally one sigma bond, one pi bond, in that there is no doubt, but some places exception comes. Okay, sir, now carbon dioxide we said regarding this. Okay, now central atom carbon is having two sigma bond pairs. Here central atom carbon is having two sigma bond pairs, we can say, and two pi bond pairs, we can say. Two pi bond pairs, one pi bond, one pi bond, two pi bond pairs are there. So central atom carbon is having two sigma bond pairs and two pi bond pairs. Okay, sigma bond pairs can be explained by hybrid orbitals. Hybrid orbitals can explain sigma bond formation. Then hybrid orbitals can hold even lone pairs, but hybrid orbitals cannot explain formation of formation of pi bonds. Hybrid orbitals cannot explain formation of pi bonds. Pi bonds will be explained by pure orbitals only. Pure orbitals only can explain pi bond formation. Hybrid orbitals never explain pi bond formation, sir. Now hybrid orbit, so to explain pi bond formation, we cannot take hybrid orbital. Okay, now so carbon is having how many sigma bonds? In the sense, two sigma bonds are there, therefore carbon is providing two hybrid orbitals for forming two sigma bonds. So two hybrid orbitals means two atomic orbitals from this carbon undergo intermixing. One atomic orbital is 2s, one atomic orbital is 2s, and another atomic orbital is 2p. So one 2p orbital. Therefore in this carbon one 2s orbital and one 2p orbital undergo intermixing. Remaining what in the sense, two 2p orbitals are there. Remaining what in the sense, two 2p orbitals are there. Suppose it is 2pz orbital, in the sense 2px orbital, 2py orbital are not going for intermixing. They are remaining in pure form. Okay. Next, now these two orbitals, that means one 2s orbital, one 2pz orbital undergoing intermixing. Therefore, we are getting hybrid orbitals. What is the name of hybrid orbital means sp? How many hybrid orbitals we are getting in the sense? Two hybrid orbitals we are getting. We are getting two hybrid orbitals. The two hybrid orbitals nature is what means sp nature. This hybrid orbital name is sp. This hybrid orbital name is sp. Hybrid orbital. How to represent hybrid orbital means one lobe is big lobe we have to give, one lobe is small lobe we have to give. It is one hybrid orbital sp. Another sp hybrid orbital how to give means like this only, one lobe is big, one lobe is small. It is one sp hybrid orbital. This 2px atomic orbital has not gone for intermixing, therefore it is in the form of a 2px orbital only. 2px orbital in the sense it is a dumbbell shape in the sense this lobe and this lobe will have same size. And this 2py atomic orbital also not going for intermixing, it is as a pure form only, that is in dumbbell shape. Okay, so this carbon is providing what are the orbitals for bonding, in the sense two sp hybrid orbitals and one 2px orbital and one 2py orbital for bonding, sir. Carbon valence shell is having four electrons. That four electrons will distribute equally into these orbitals, one for this sp, one for this sp, one for this 2px, one for this 2py. So four unpaired electrons, four electrons in the valence shell of carbon is distributed equally into these four orbitals, sir. Now these two sp hybrid orbitals orient around the nucleus of carbon and makes a linear shape, because a linear shape in the sense repulsion will be minimum, stability will be maximum. So in this carbon nucleus is surrounded by two sp hybrid orbitals. They are orienting with a 180 degree, sir. Now it is a carbon nucleus, it is the nucleus of carbon. This is having a nucleus of carbon. We are writing one hybrid orbital we are writing here, and another hybrid orbital we are writing here. So this is sp hybrid orbital, this is sp hybrid orbital. Each hybrid orbital is having one unpaired electron. Each hybrid orbital is having one unpaired electron, we can say. Okay, so regarding sp hybrid orbitals we said, sir. Okay, next, regarding this 2px and 2py atomic orbital we will say later. So for carbon, from carbon we have considered two sp hybrid orbitals. These two sp hybrid orbitals orient linearly with 180 degree. Then we will take oxygen. This oxygen, in the sense oxygen electronic configuration is like this. In this oxygen two unpaired electrons are there. Suppose this unpaired electron is 2py, this is unpaired electron is 2pz. Okay, this is a 2p atomic orbitals. Okay, sir, in this oxygen we will take one unpaired electron from 2p orbital, that we will take. Okay, so oxygen one 2p orbital, one unpaired electron. Okay, it is 2p orbital of oxygen. Okay, another oxygen atom 2p orbital, another oxygen atom 2p orbital, it is having one unpaired electron. Okay, now this carbon sp hybrid orbital is orienting with this oxygen 2p orbital. Okay, now carbon sp orbital is orienting with the oxygen 2p orbital and forming what bond? In the sense, sigma bond is formed. In this sigma bond is formed by carbon sp orbital, oxygen, this oxygen 2p orbital, oxygen 2p orbital. Therefore, this sigma bond is called a sigma sp. Next, this sp orbital of carbon and this 2p orbital of oxygen undergo intermixing. Now, sp orbital of carbon and 2p orbital of oxygen undergo intermixing. Okay, here nucleus is there. Here two electrons. Now, this sigma bond is formed by sp orbital of carbon and p orbital of oxygen intermixing. That means overlapping to give this sigma bond. Okay, so between between this oxygen and carbon, one sigma bond is there. Between this carbon and oxygen, one sigma bond is there. Okay, so we have written two sigma bonds. That means this carbon is forming two sigma bonds. We said this carbon is forming two sigma bonds. Okay, now we will say about pi bonds. We will say now we will go for what in the sense of pi bonds. Okay, regarding pi bonds, we will see. Now this carbon, valence shell has provided these orbitals. This sp orbital and this sp orbital have gone for sigma bonding over. Now remaining these two. Now carbon is having this 2px orbital and this 2py orbital. This carbon is having this 2px and 2py orbitals. That two orbitals we will take. Okay, sir. Now carbon nucleus we are considering. This is one sigma bond with what in the sense oxygen nucleus. This is a oxygen nucleus. Okay. Oxygen nucleus, it is carbon nucleus. Between carbon and oxygen, one sigma bond we have written. This side, one sigma bond between oxygen and carbon. So now it is oxygen nucleus. Okay. This oxygen nucleus, carbon nucleus. Between them, one sigma bond. This carbon nucleus, this oxygen nucleus, between them, one sigma bond. Okay. So now This carbon is having this 2px orbital and this 2py orbital. These two atomic orbitals orient in what manner? That we will see. Okay. Now this is a 2px orbital. This is a perpendicular to this internuclear axis. Okay. So what is internuclear axis? We will see. Here we are drawing one imaginary axis here. This imaginary axis is passing through center of this nucleus, center of this nucleus. Therefore, this imaginary axis is called the internuclear axis. Now, this 2px atomic orbital, is perpendicular to the internuclear axis. This 2px atomic orbital is perpendicular to the internuclear axis. Okay. Then we will take here one orbital we'll take. In this oxygen, one orbital we are taking. This orbital already has gone for sigma bonding over. Now we will take this orbital. This orbital name I will take it as 2px. Okay. So oxygen is providing 2px orbital. Okay. Now these two 2px orbitals. Okay. These two 2px orbitals are perpendicular to internuclear axis. And they are parallel to each other. Therefore, between them, what bond is formed? In the sense, pi bond is formed. Okay. So between them, what bond is formed means pi bond is formed, we can say. So remember that pi bond is possible between pure atomic orbitals, but not hybrid orbitals. Hybrid orbitals never form pi bonds. Pure atomic orbitals only will form pi bonds. Okay. So this 2px orbital and this 2px orbital, they are parallel to each other and they are perpendicular to internuclear axis. Therefore, they are going for lateral overlapping, otherwise sideways overlapping to give pi bond. Okay. Sir, next, we will take this carbon. in this carbon, these two hybrid orbitals have gone for sigma bonds over. This orbital have gone for pi bond is over. Now remaining this orbital is there. So in this carbon, 2py orbital remaining is there. That 2py orbital will take. Okay, that 2py orbital I will take like this. So in this carbon, 2py orbital is there. That 2py orbital I am taking. 2py orbital I am taking. This 2py orbital. Okay, this 2py orbital. This 2py orbital of carbon is perpendicular to internuclear axis. Perpendicular to internuclear axis and perpendicular to this pi bond. Perpendicular to this pi bond. That means otherwise perpendicular to 2px orbital. Perpendicular to 2px orbital. This 2py orbital. This 2py orbital is perpendicular to this internuclear axis as well as perpendicular to this 2px orbital. Okay, like this is there. Next, we will take another oxygen atom. In the another oxygen atom, two unpaired electrons are there. One unpaired electron already has gone for a sigma bonding with the carbon. Another unpaired electron is there. This unpaired electron now we will take as 2py, not 2px. Okay, so we are taking as 2py. So this is having one unpaired electron. That unpaired electron in 2py atomic orbital we have taken. Okay, so 2py. Now these two 2py atomic orbitals, these two, that means from oxygen and carbon, these two 2py atomic orbitals are perpendicular to the internuclear axis, but they are parallel to each other. They are parallel to each other. Since they are parallel to each other, between them what bond is formed means pi bond is formed. Okay, here pi bond is formed. This pi bond is formed by overlapping of pure atomic orbitals but not hybrid orbitals. So pi bond is possible. Okay, so pi bond means you use pure orbital overlapping concept. Pi bond means use pure orbital overlapping concept but not hybrid orbitals. Okay, so in the carbon dioxide, central atom is carbon. Carbon is having what hybridization means? Sp hybridization. Sir, okay, so now we have explained about carbon dioxide, we have explained. Now we will take some other molecule. For example, sulfur dioxide will take. In sulfur dioxide, what is the central atom? In the sense, sulfur is the central atom. This sulfur is having, is coming under group 6th group. Therefore, this valence shell is having 6 electrons. This valence shell is having 6 electrons, we have written. Oxygen, two oxygen atoms, the two oxygen atoms we will write. Oxygen comes under 6th group. Therefore, this valence shell is having 6 electrons. Oxygen valence shell is having 6 electrons. Okay, 6 electrons we have written. Now, generally oxygen will make double bond. Generally oxygen will make double bond, otherwise two single bonds. Okay, so generally oxygen will make double bond, so we have written double bond. Generally oxygen makes a double bond, otherwise two single bonds. Okay, sorry. Now this oxygen has a double bond. Now in this oxygen, two lone pairs are there, two bond pairs are there. Therefore, this oxygen is having 8 electrons in its valence shell, so it has octet configuration. Similarly, this oxygen. Now we will take this sulfur. This sulfur valence shell is having 4 bonds. 4 bonds means 8 electrons plus 1 lone pair. So plus 2 electrons, 10 electrons. Therefore, it is a electron-rich molecule. It is having electrons. Sulfur valence shell is having electrons more than octet. Therefore, it is electron-rich molecule, we can say. Now, in this sulfur, sulfur valence shell is having one lone pair, then two sigma bond pairs are there, and two pi bond pairs are there. Okay, so sulfur valence shell is having one lone pair and two sigma bonds, two pi bonds. Okay, now sulfur electronic configuration will write, that is a neon, 3s2, 3p4, 3p4, 3d0. Now we will write electronic configuration. S is having one orbital. P is having three orbitals. D is having a 5 orbitals, you know. Sir, sulfur electronic configuration we have written. Then we will write oxygen. Oxygen electronic configuration. Oxygen is having helium. Helium 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4. So 2s is having 2 electrons. 2p is having 4 electrons. 2p is having 4 electrons. That we have written. Now I will take another oxygen atom. For another oxygen atom also we will write as it is same. Okay, so 2s2 2p4, 2s contains 2 electrons, 2p contains 4 electrons, that we will write like this, sir. Now in this sulfur, one lone pair is there, 2 sigma 1 pairs are there. This can be explained by hybridization. Okay, lone pair and sigma 1 formation can be explained by hybridization. So sulfur is having one lone pair and 2 sigma 1 pairs, totally 3. So 3 hybrid orbital sulfur is providing. So 3 atomic orbitals from sulfur undergo intermixing. 3 atomic orbitals means 1 is 3s and 2 3p orbitals. So 1 3s orbital, 1 3s orbital and 1 3s orbital and 2 3p orbitals undergo intermixing. So due to that hybrid orbitals formed. How many hybrid orbitals formed? In the sense, 3 hybrid orbitals formed. The hybrid orbital name is called sp2 hybrid orbital. Then the sulfur is having 2 pi bonds. Sulfur is having 2 pi bonds, therefore sulfur is providing 2 atomic orbitals for pi bonding. This 3p for pi bonding, it is called a 3p atomic orbital. Another one is what means this 3d. This 3d in the sense 3d is called a double dumbbell. Therefore, we'll write a double dumbbell. It is 3d for pi bonding. So sulfur is providing 3 hybrid orbitals, 1 hybrid orbital for this lone pair, 2 hybrid orbitals for 2 sigma bonds, and 2 pure orbitals it is providing for making pi bonds. 1 pure orbital is 3p, another pure orbital is 3d. Okay. Now sulfur valence shell is having 6 electrons. That 6 electrons how to fill? In the sense, 2 electrons we will give to one sp2 orbital which act as a lone pair. Okay, remaining 4 electrons, 1 electron here for forming sigma bond, 1 electron here for forming sigma bond, 1 electron here for forming pi bond, 1 electron here for forming pi bond. Okay, so sulfur valence shell is having 4 unpaired electrons. These 4 unpaired electrons forming 2 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds. This is electron pair, it is acting as a lone pair. Okay, now we will see regarding bonding. Now this sulfur sp2 orbital and oxygen 2p orbital forming sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by sulfur sp2 orbital, oxygen 2p orbital. Okay, so one sigma bond we set. Next, sulfur sp2 orbital, sulfur sp2 orbital, another oxygen atom 2p orbital forming sigma bond. Sulfur sp2 orbital, another oxygen atom 2p orbital forming sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by sulfur sp2 orbital, oxygen p orbital. Okay, next pi bonds we have to say. So 2 pi bonds are there. Now sulfur 3p orbital, sulfur 3p orbital, oxygen 2p orbital undergoing lateral overlapping and forming pi bond. Now see that this pi bond is formed by sulfur p orbital and oxygen p orbital. Therefore this pi bond we can write p pi. That means sulfur is providing p orbital for forming pi bond, oxygen also providing p orbital for pi bonding. Sir, next to pi bond, sulfur is providing 3d orbital, oxygen is providing 2p orbital for forming pi bond. So in this pi bond is formed by sulfur 3d orbital, oxygen p orbital. Therefore sulfur is providing d orbital for forming pi bond, oxygen is providing p orbital for pi bonding. Therefore this pi bond is called d pi p pi. That means sulfur is providing d orbital, oxygen